Welcome to another one of Day One's 5 in 5 series where we help answer how-to questions for the retail store owner. So today we'll be talking about 5 things your staff might be doing that annoys customers and are costing you sales for your retail outlet. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe and click on the notification button so that you get alerted whenever we release new episodes each and every week. Without further ado, let's jump straight into it. Now, the first way your staff might be unconsciously annoying customers is when they don't know when to approach customers and when to give the customers space. The art of approaching customers could really make or break a sale in your store. Now, for example, when a customer is looking at an item in your store and they're deliberating over whether or not they want to purchase it, and your staff very timely comes over and informs them that there's a 20% sale going on for that item they're holding, this could very well mean a sale for your store and an immediate conversion. Now, compare that to if, let's say, a customer is browsing an item in your store and they're not interested in buying, and your staff comes over and starts talking about the whole product specs of the item and why it's so great. Now, this could very well be the trigger that makes the customer feel as if they just want to exit your store there and then. So this kind of showcases how your staff behavior to customers, whether or not they are informed, whether or not they know when to approach the customer and when to give space. Now, this is why your staff knowing when they should approach the customer and when they should not is so important for your store's success. The art of sales is a never-ending one, but there are some key basic fundamentals that we can apply to each and every sale. So for example, if a customer is looking at an item for a prolonged period of time and they're looking at a price tag, turning the price tag over, checking the material, checking the item itself, you can be sure that this customer is in the stage whereby they're really deliberating over whether or not this item is worth the purchase. So if you inform your staff, what they can do is that they can now begin looking out for these behaviors within certain buyers, within certain customers in your store, and then you can inform your staff that whenever they come across customers that have this behavior, display this behavior, they can begin coming in and informing the customer about why this product is so great, or a current offer or promotion that this item is a part of, or even maybe even assuring the customer how this item is really, really a great value buy. Another thing also is if you see a customer looking at an item and then looking at their phone, what you can determine from this is that the customer is probably going online to see whether or not the same item is being sold at other places at a cheaper price. So whenever a customer is doing this, this is more for the tech-savvy customers. You can really be certain that these customers are already sold on your product, on that specific product. They're just unsure about price. So when you're able to come and inform your staff to approach these types of customers and inform them how actually the price is the lowest, or when they're online, there's no warranty, but in their store, there's a warranty even at a slightly higher price. Now, these are ways you can actually overcome the objection in the customer's head when they're looking online to see whether there are alternatives to this product that they're already more or less decided on. So by your staff being informed and being trained how to approach these different archetypes of customers in your store, look out for the key behavior that indicate whether or not the customer is ready to buy but uncertain about price, or whether or not the customer is really still unsure about the products in your store. Now, this can really make the difference between your staff being well trained to optimize the sale or not. So all in all, not knowing the right time to approach customers in your store is one thing that your staff could be doing that is unconsciously annoying your customers. Now, the second way your staff might be unconsciously annoying customers is when your staff are not being available when they're needed. Now, whether or not customers are the extroverted type that like to engage and interact with everyone, or the introverted type who seem as if they really just want to be alone, nobody enjoys feeling invisible whenever they are ready to purchase or whenever they are ready to ask a question from your staff and get help. So the key distinction here is to realize that even though customers might usually want to keep to themselves until they find an item they like, most times when there's interest already and when they're ready, they're more or less sold on the product, they want to find out more. Customers expect staff to be readily available to inform them, right? To overcome the information, or rather give them the information they need to make an informed purchase. So one thing you can implement into your store is to get your staff to always be located near the center of your store. Now, when they're located at the center of your store, they will now have a bird's eye view of the customers coming into and out of your shop. And this way, they can really be able to tell which customers are looking around for help and which customers want to be left alone. And then, this is how you can make sure that the customers that need help get the help they receive, And by getting the help they receive, they make a more informed decision, they feel more certain about their purchase. Another thing you can adopt here is to make sure that all your staff have a uniform that allows customers to easily identify them. Now this way, whenever customers need help, they know exactly who they can approach to get the help they need, again, to make an informed purchase. Now the third way your staff might be unknowingly annoying customers is when your staff do not know critical information about products in your store. Customers that are ready to buy want to make sure and feel confident that this is the best value buy they can get, and they do this by finding out more details about the price, by finding out more about the benefits of the product, by finding out more about the offer, by finding out more about, let's say, the guarantee, by finding out more about more details, basically critical information about the product. So with that being said, if your staff are not being trained to know exactly the critical details of each and every product in your store, how then can your staff provide these crucial information when the customer feels already ready to buy a product and they just want to confirm that this is the best value purchase? Keep in mind here that customers love to be educated, okay? If they are selling, let's say, headphones, what's the difference between this $99 headphone as compared to this $399 headphone? Right, they want to find out what is the difference, what accounts for the difference in price, what makes this $399 headphone better than the $99 one. Could it be the battery life or maybe the sound quality? So if your staff is not being able to provide this information to the customer will feel more assured whether or not whichever product they're going to buy, what's the difference in the products, you know, why they should be buying one over the other. Another example here is if a customer walks into your store wanting to buy an anniversary gift for their wife who, say, has sensitive skin. So in this case, the customer wants to make an informed decision. Which are the items in the store that fit what he really needs, right? A nice gift, anniversary gift for his wife that also keeps into consideration the fact that his wife has sensitive skin. So in this case, if your staff actually knows very clearly what items are in the store, what are the details of these items, what are the critical information of these items, he or she can now make an informed decision. He can now evaluate what are the items that fit within the range of this customer and provide the suggestions here. Now, when this is done the right way, your customer will feel very valued as a customer, feel as if their needs are being heard, are being met. And in this case, because of that added service, the customer is very, very much more likely to buy when they know that your staff has actually put in the effort, put in the time, put in the energy to think about the right products they can offer. When customers have questions and sales representatives, your staff do not have the answers, that is where there is lost sales right there. Okay, how else would a customer know that the $399 headphone will work better for his situation when he usually travels abroad a lot and likes to listen to his music for hours long, for long hours of flight? How else would a customer know that, oh, these earrings look great? Not only do they look great, but they're also hypoallergenic, which means they are the right item for their wife who actually has the allergic skin. How would the customers know these differences? How would the customers then make a really informed decision? How else would the customers feel good about their decision and feel good about the purchase that they are really considering to make? Right. So making sure your staff is really clear on this critical information is crucial for your store. And this is one other way you annoy customers when your staff doesn't know this crucial information. So moving on, the fourth thing your staff does that might unknowingly annoy customers is by not knowing when to give customers space. Now, even if you're a retail store owner yourself, you're most likely also a consumer at some other points in your life. You're also a buyer in some other points in your life. What could be less annoying than browsing a store's items and having a staff tell you for the duration you're there? Wasn't it pressurizing? Didn't you feel as if you just wanted your own space to leisurely walk the aisles and browse the items? So this is another way your staff might be unknowingly annoying customers in not knowing when to give them space, not knowing how much space to give customers. Now this also ties in with point number two earlier, where we suggested that your staff should be trained to always be situated near the center of your store. This is something you can adopt here as well. When your staff are trained to be situated near the center of your store and give customer space and only approach customers asking if they need help whenever a customer gives the behavioral cues that they're looking for help. Now this will really help you to curb this very, very crucial point here where customers feel as if they're being overly pressured, right? They don't have enough space in your store. So I'm sure I'm not the only one who has ever left the store because I felt there was too much pressure. So in this case, you just need to keep a lookout. Make sure you observe your staff. Make sure they're not tailing customers. Make sure they're giving your customers enough space, because if not, it could be really annoying, and this would then also lose you the sale. So the fifth way your staff is unknowingly annoying customers is when they don't know how to read body language and behavioral cues. So I'm just going to lay out a few simple heuristics, a few simple points you can inform your staff. Firstly, for lovebirds who are holding hands in your store, they typically don't want to get disturbed, right? Just someone leave the lovebirds alone. Next, do not talk to anyone who's wearing a earpiece. They probably don't want to be disturbed as well. You know, this is an obvious one. I myself, actually, I'm guilty of this. I've ever walked around shopping with earpiece that wasn't playing any music because I didn't want to be disturbed. I wanted to just be left alone. The third thing also is a quick and simple rule. Whenever a staff walks by a baby, a pram, make sure they smile at the baby. So this is a little trick that does wonders. And finally, also for your store, you can implement a rule whereby, you know, for every customer that walks in with carrying really heavy bags or many bags, make sure that you inform your staff. They can always tell the person carrying lots of bags that they have the option to leave their bags at the counter to be taken care of, while they can browse leisurely without having to carry the burdensome bags in their hands all the way, right? So this will do wonders again in the quality of service that customers feel in your store. And when your customers feel comfortable in your store, that's when they're in the best state to actually purchase more and more ready to actually buy items from your store. So finally, this has been the final point for this 5 in 5 series, where we talk about 5 ways your staff might unknowingly be annoying customers. We hope you guys enjoyed this one. And also right here, I want to insert a really quick plug that if you're on our Day One app, which is absolutely free, you can actually share this video there and then to all your staff just by using our app interface. And not only that, you can actually track actions that your staff might be doing and manage your team without actually physically being in your store. So if you haven't already, check out the link in the description where you can download our We Are Day One app for free, and I'll see you there as well. So with that being said, this has been Johan Tang from We Are Day One, and I will see you on the next one. Bye.